Hey guys, what's up? This is your friend and tutor Manas, and it's gonna be yet another session in this lecture series on engineering mechanics. Today we're gonna be taking up a problem based on dynamics, and its description can be seen at the bottom of your screen. Okay, now let me explain this to you, what this entire arrangement is all about. So there are basically two blocks in the form of M1 and M2. They have been connected together with the help of a pulley. All right, now the mass for block one is 10 kgs, the mass for block 2 is 5 kgs, and there is some sort of friction between this block and this surface over here. The coefficient of friction has been given as 0.25. okay, so what we are supposed to do is we have to calculate two things. One is the amount of tension generated in the spring, and the second thing is amount of acceleration. So what basically is happening if this entire system is released from the state of equilibrium, then in that case this block will move downwards and this block will move in the right hand side direction. Or you can also say this block will travel in the downward direction with an acceleration A, and this block M1 over here will travel towards the right hand side with an acceleration A. And this is something which we're going to be calculating. Okay, again, I'm going to be applying the Newton's second law of motion to calculate those two values, tension and acceleration. So guys, let's kick off by doing the analysis for block M1. Let's do this. Okay, so when you speak of block M1, this string is going to pull this block, okay, by a tension of T, right? And at the same time, we know very well that the weight of the block is going to act in the downward direction. Now mass is how much? It's 10 kgs. So the weight W1 is going to be equal to, obviously it's going to be mg, that means 10 times of g. G is nothing but the acceleration due to gravity, whose value, g's value can be taken as, let me write it somewhere, 9.81 meters per second square. Anyways, this is mass, weight is going to act downwards, so this is going to be equal to 10 g. Now this is acting in the downward direction, so there is going to be some reaction offered from the surface perpendicular to this, okay, something of this sort. So let's say that this reaction is given by, say, N. That's it. All right, so let's frame this first equation. Summation of all the forces in y direction is equal to zero. Y is equal to zero because there is no movement along the y direction. Therefore the force which is upwards, positive, downwards, negative. So we can essentially write this as N minus 10g equals to zero. Or you can also say the value of reaction works out as 10 times of g. Done. What's next? Okay, this block is moving in this direction, so there is going to be a friction force which is going to act somewhere along this direction, this way. Okay, now guys, remember, friction force, small f, is given as coefficient of friction multiplied by the reaction, mu n. So n has already been calculated, which is equal to 10 g, and the value of friction is 0.25. so this is going to be 0.25 multiplied by n is how much? It's 10 g. So I can write this as 10 g. So essentially this works out as 2.5 times of g, and that's the value of the friction force over here. So f equals 2.5 g. okay, let me write this in brackets, 2.5 g. that's the total amount of friction acting towards the left hand side. Okay, now let me frame another equation. This is where I'm going to be using the Newton's second law of motion. Summation of all the forces is equal to mass into acceleration. The block one analysis is going on right now, so the mass of block one has to be taken into account. It is moving towards the right with an acceleration A. That's why we have written A over here. And since all of this motion is taking place in the x-axis or along the x-axis, so I'm going to write F of x over here. Okay, so what are these forces? Left hand side. Now guys, whenever you are solving problems with related to Newton's laws of motion, always try to work out what are the forces that are dominating the motion. So you can clearly see, since the motion is towards the right hand side, and the force towards the right hand side is this one, this T, that means this T is dominating, okay, with respect to this friction force. So what we can do is has to be taken as positive. T, this is towards the left, minus friction force whose magnitude is 2.5 g, and that's it. That's all the forces that we've got will be equal to the mass. How much is the mass? m1, where is m1? It's 10 kgs times of acceleration, that's a. Okay, let us say that this is equation number one.
Done and dusted. Block one analysis is over. Now let's carry out the same analysis for block two. Okay, so it's going to be something like this. Very simple. Let me write this quickly. Block M2. Okay. Now you can clearly see that the motion is happening along the vertical axis. Now check which force is dominating, and for that I need to apply the force over here. So obviously this string, and there is going to be some weight. Okay, let me rub this right now. Weight of this block. So weight is mg. Mg, how much is m? M is 5. So I can write 5g over here, where g represents the acceleration due to gravity. And due to this weight, there is going to be a tension. Okay? Okay, which is going to have a magnitude of t. All right. Between these two forces, can you tell me which force is dominating? Now, since the motion is happening in the downward direction, that means you can claim that this force, 5g force, is dominating. Therefore, this will be taken as positive, and the force opposite to this one, that is this tension T, will be taken as negative. That's the sign convention that we're going to be following right now. And here we go. Summation of all the forces in y direction is equal to mass into acceleration. So the block for which analysis is being done right now is block 2. It's going to be M2A, and the acceleration with which it is going downwards is represented by A. That's why we've written A over here. All right. So the force dominating is this one, 5G. Okay. Right now we're taking the direction of dominating force as positive. Okay. So this will be taken as positive, and this over here will be taken as negative. That's why this is 5G positive. T will be taken as negative. So let me write this. 5g minus t is equal to mass into acceleration, block 2 mass, 5 kg, 5 times of a, and that's it. That's equation number 2. Now you can clearly see that we have to calculate two outputs in the form of tension and acceleration. We have two equations. Okay, this is unknown t, and this also is unknown to us, acceleration, t and a. We have two equations, we have two unknowns. G is already known to us. How much is it? 9.81. So the best thing to do right now, you can clearly see this t is positive over here, this t is negative. So what I'll do is I'll add these two equations, equation 1 plus equation 2, and let's see what happens. So t minus 2.5g, let me write this in totality, t minus 2.5g, okay, then plus 5g minus t is equivalent to how much? This is 10a and this is 5a. So 10 plus 5a. So guys, you can clearly see these two things will cancel out. 5g minus 2.5g is obviously 2.5g only, which is going to be equal to 10 plus 5 is 15, 15a. So acceleration will work out as 2.5g over 15. 2.5g, and the value of g is how much? It's 9.81 over what? It's going to be 15. So the value of acceleration works out as, let me rub this. Okay, I'm sure you guys must have noted that friction thing. Okay, I need some space over here. So the value of acceleration is going to work out as, let me check how much it is. You can do this calculation in a calculator, and this eventually works out as 1.635 meters per second square. 1.635 meters per second square. So that's the value of acceleration obtained. Now you can put this value of acceleration in either equation 2 or in equation 1 to get the value of tension T. It's going to be very simple. Now let's frame this equation 2 in a better way. So I can write this as 5g minus t. Let's take t over to the right hand side, and 5a will come over here. So t is equal to 5g minus 5a. T equals 5g minus 5a. So you just need to put the value of g and a, and eventually you're going to get the value of tension T. So tension T will be equal to 5 times of 9.81 minus 5 times of acceleration 1.635. You just do this calculation and the value of T shall work out as, let me tell you, 40.875 newtons. So that's it. That's the tension T in the string, and that's the acceleration with which this entire system is gonna move. Okay, block M2 will go downwards with an acceleration of 1.63, and block M1 will move right inside with an acceleration of 1.635. So guys, that was all from my side for today. If you've got any doubt or query, do write them down in the comment section below. I'll be very happy to answer them. And if you believe that this video tutorial has added value to your knowledge of engineering mechanics, then do share and like this video, subscribe to this channel, and also press the bell icon so that whenever I upload a new video, you get a notification, you get an update. Anyways, I'm going to be back with more such videos on mechanics and drawing. Until then, it's a wrap. This is Manas Patnaik signing off. Take care. Have a great day. Keep learning.